In 1964, as Beatlemania consumed America, September brought the Fab Four to Indiana. They clowned around on the Indianapolis Motor Speedway's golf course, met the state fair queen, and played two concerts to screaming crowds at the state fairgrounds.
On behalf of all of the state fair board and all the good guys in WIFE, may I present the Beatles!
It had been a hard day's night for Wabash fans. The Monon Bell had been in DePauw's possession for 9 straight years. It was also a presidential election year. The son of candidate Barry Goldwater and a freshman senator named Birch Bayh both spoke at DePauw. On to the day of decision in Crawfordsville. This short pass from Bruce Mackey to Chuck Byram wound up being a 55-yard gainer and set up the day's first score. A few plays later, as the second quarter began, Bill Elcott capped the 99-yard drive with a 2-yard run. A nifty fake by Mackey created a hole and a 4-yard touchdown gallop. It was 14-0 Tigers. That was the tally as the halftime gun sounded, but Wabash showed life in quarter number 3. Little Giant fullback Alan Anderson plunged in, and a 2-point conversion made it 14-8. Another TD and a 2-point play, not captured on film, gave Wabash a 15-14 advantage. As he drops back for a pass, DePauw's Mackey finds no one open and takes matters into his own hands. 24 yards later, he had reached the end zone virtually untouched. A gutsy decision by Coach Tom Mott to go for 2 paid off. It gave DePauw a 7-point lead. Wabash scored a 4th-quarter TD and opted for 2 and the win. Anderson tried to take it in from the right, the play that worked for the touchdown, but cornerback Todd Eberle stopped him just shy of the goal line. And the headline in the DePauw says it all. Yeah, yeah, yeah.